What's up, everybody? I am BK, BKBangers.com. Welcome to another video. Today's video, I'm addressing some comments, questions, and concerns that was posted in some videos that I did previously. DCP Tracks and Anthony Johnson posted a question on the video that I did last month. I think it was like May 29th, on how to set up the MPC as a plugin with the new Studio 1.4. So I'm gonna address both you guys' questions in one video. I'm gonna try to do this as quick as I can. So let's start with Anthony's question. No, we'll start with DCP Track's question first. So DCP wants to know, basically, he said that I missed a step. I'm not sure what step you were talking about that I missed, because I did two videos on how to set up the plugin in Studio 1.4. And the second one was because I had missed a step, and I then did the second one just to cover what I missed. Now this is a third one, and I'm not really doing another one after this on how to set it up, right? So this is the MPC plugin. Once you have the MPC plugin open, you will then load it up with your sounds. Your sounds are then placed on the pads. Once your sounds are placed on the pads, you then go into Pad Mixer. So you when you open it up, it'll be here. You drag in your sounds, you load it up. You would go to the Pad Mixer, because this is where your programs are. In the Channel Mixer, this is where like your plugins and your program samples, whatever, all of them will be loaded across here. Right, for whatever reason, I'm gonna tackle this in another video or with Presonus themselves, but for whatever reason, the MPC plugin is only picking up one program, so I cannot load more than one. See here, I have two programs. If this was standalone MPC software DAW, all the programs would be across here. So for whatever reason, it's only showing one program, and I'm gonna tackle that in another video. But so now you have your program, your pads. You go into pad one, or all your pads from pad 1 through 16. You then go into stereo output 1 and 2, and you go along the line. So the next pad 2 would be 3 and 4, output 3 and 4, so on and so forth. Once you have that completed, you X out of the MPC plugin, you go into the mix window. Inside of your mix window, you might not see it looking like how it was just now. You would have to click instruments in order to see this. When you see the MPC or whatever you titled your MPC, you go to expand. Now, these are all the outputs from 1 to 31. These are all the outputs. So this is 1, right? If I hit pad 2, you hear nothing. Well, if I open it, you hear it now, right? So those are the sounds that I have on there, right? So now you don't need that there anymore. If you want to see your tracks here and record on here, right here, in the on the canvas, you would add a new track, existing track. You can leave it default, none. Press OK. You come here and if this thing will open, See here, it says none. You want to change it from none to MPC. Right here where it says MPC public, you want to change that to, I have an MPK mini, so I use my MPK mini, but you can also use the QWERTY keyboard, which is if you press caps lock, it'll pop up, right? So you can also use the QWERTY keyboard. Now for Anthony, you wanted to know why your MPC is not recording on the track. For whatever reason, don't feel bad. It's happening to me as well. If I press record here on the MPC, it won't record. See, nothing recorded. So, boom, I get rid of that. So there was one step that I missed, and I covered it in another video, but I'm gonna cover it one more time. When you set up your pads, you want to go to this little section over here, go to edit, go down to program, go to note mapping. You want to set your note mapping to chromatic. If it's on classic MPC, it won't work inside the Studio One. You want to set it to chromatic. Alright, trust me, I'm not going to go into the details of why, but in order for it to work, that's what you need to do. So I missed that step, I covered it. Now, you just seen that I recorded from the MPC and it didn't record. I'm not sure why is that happening, but the remedy is to either click in the MIDI notes, or if you want to use another controller or the QWERTY keyboard, that's what you do. So I'm going to use my MPC, my MPK mini. And as you can see, I'm getting sound. If I hit record, right? So it's there. And it's the same as if I use the QWERTY keyboard. So I bring up the QWERTY keyboard. Now you want to use your arrow key to go down to C-2. I press record. Right, so, all right, so that's out the way. That's how you record from inside on the MPC itself. Now to save it as a template, as you can see here, I have MPC templates. I also have MIDI control, Studio One MPC One. In order to do that, you would go here, store as preset. It'll come up with a name. You title it whatever. Whatever. Boom. You put a subfolder if you want to. I have a subfolder because I'm going to create more than one of these when I get a bunch of different drum programs that I want to move around with. I'm going to save more than one. Right, you click OK. Once you click OK, it's here, right? And that's how you save your template in a nutshell. And it's pretty simple. Is that simple? I'm not sure of the step that the gentleman said that I missed, but I hope I covered it all here in this video. I'm not doing any more of these. I'll try to answer your questions inside of the comment section. But this is the last template video that I'm going to do because I already did three of them, right? This will be the fourth one actually, because I did one with Studio One 3. a year or two ago, right? So this will pretty much be it until maybe Studio One 4.5 or Studio One 5. You know what I'm saying? And that's pretty much it. Once you save and store the template, you can then also, because every time you open up the template, these drums will be here. So what you can do is you can actually set up each individual pad and then store that as a template and then drop your drums on the pad. So what I mean is you can go to pad mixer with a default when you open up the default, right? And you can go through pads. See, right now you only see 2, 4, 6, 7 pads because I only have 7 sounds on the in the program. And that's how the MPC works. It only pulls up the sounds that you actually have. If you want to see all of them, I believe, what is it? Well, it used to be an option that you could see. You can see the unused versions, but for whatever reason, it's not here. So forget that. Or they moved it. I don't know where they moved it to, but whatever. We're not worrying about that. So basically, what I'm trying to say is that you can come in here, change around the pads. Once you have sounds on it, erase the sounds, change all the outputs, and then store it as a template, as a preset. And that's it in a nutshell. That is how you store presets with your MPC in Studio One 4, and that is how you record your MPC. You have to use either the QWERTY keyboard or a MIDI controller. The MPC currently, for whatever reason, it's not respecting the MIDI input. So that's pretty much it, y'all. Do remember that music is life. It is our DNA. Keep banging. Peace, love, light. Till next time. Enjoy your Independence Day. I'm not sure if I'm gonna upload anything tomorrow. If this makes it up on time, it'll be up today. If not, it'll be up tomorrow. So love and light. Till next time. Peace.